Hey everybody, this is Dave from Qlik. Today we're going to talk about Jethro and Qlik and accelerating big data ecosystems and accelerating visualization and analytics. So first we need to understand what are the challenges of the BI on Hadoop world. Well, let's talk a little bit about why analytics on Hadoop fail. Well, let's start with the data lake concept. Data lakes are not designed for ad hoc or interactive queries or interactive query tools. And because of Hadoop's nature, it's designed primarily to run batch processes, machine learning, and ETL jobs. Hadoop is also really not designed for your business analyst. It's really designed for a data scientist. So Qlik works with Jethro to accelerate and bridge the gap between business and IT. It allows visual analytics on Hadoop. So now that we understand the problem, let's take a look at how we can solve this. So we're going to watch a demo here of Qlik running against 3 billion records on the Jethro acceleration engine using Qlik in direct discovery or live query mode against, again, 3 billion records stored within a Hadoop file system. So let's go ahead and take a look. So let's go ahead and get started with a demo here. And we're going to go ahead and open up one of our apps here and take a look at what's inside. And we can see that we've got a dashboard sheet. And we're going to take a look at that. And what we'll see here is Qlik and Jethro working together to do a live query against almost 3 billion records. Now let's start interacting here. So I'm going to go ahead and choose an item class, make a selection, and watch Jethro perform in real time against the backend system. So in less than a second, we've now whittled our selection by making one choice to go from almost 3 billion records to 17 million records. Now, if I want to continue to go in and dive down a little bit more, I'm going to go ahead and choose just white. And I want to go look at specifically white athletic shoes. And so I've now gone from 3 billion records to 387,000 records with just a couple of clicks and almost no latency on my interaction. Well, this is pretty great if I want to go and interact with the information by using filter selections. But what if I want to get more creative and I'm not exactly sure what I'm looking for? Well, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to search for WAH. And what's interesting now with Qlik Sense 3.0 is we have a combination of search and visual search. So when I typed in WA, it also gives me the ability to look at item class. It also gives me the ability to look at any of the charts or graphics that were created that contain the term WA. It gives me predictive type ahead on entities that I could look for, as well as dimensional hits on where that search entity occurs. So maybe I want to look specifically at the Walnut Grove store, and I can do that just by clicking on the button. And again, now we focused our entire dashboard on the Walnut Grove store and going again from that 3 billion records down to 65 million records. Well, this is a great start of how to use search and how to interact with the dashboard and how to make selections. But what if we want to get in and actually build some content from scratch and do real analytics with Jethro on Hadoop? Well, in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over and create a new sheet. Starting with our empty sheet, let's go ahead and edit and create some content. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go add my own bar chart here and just drag that in as you normally would. I'm going to go grab some elements here out of my master library. I'm going to grab a measure and let's go ahead and grab number of customers and I'll drag that in and go grab a dimension here and I'm going to go grab the store state and drop that in. Don't like the way that that necessarily looks, so I'll come over and make a quick change to that. But there we go. Real quick bar chart. Again, live analytics on 3 billion records using Jethro and Qlik. Now I'm going to go and grab some other elements that have already been created in my library, some pre-built visualizations. Maybe I want to grab that map from that first page and add that in. Well, one of the neat things that I see over here are some actually interesting calculations. And these are set analysis calculations. One of the great things that Jethro has done is to replicate set analysis capability in their engine. So when we make calls back to the native Hadoop system, it will go and apply that Qlik functional syntax, as we know and love as set analysis, to these calculations to give us things like current year and other types of dynamic calculations. So I'm going to go ahead and add that metric. And it'll give me a current year set analysis calculation. And maybe I'll throw in a year over year growth calculation. So I can now look at this information. I've built my own dashboard. It's giving me all this calculation capability. I can go in and filter and drill and do my exploration now in real time against these systems. And with the speed and performance we get with Jethro accelerating, caching, and optimizing the queries, we have now entered into solving those problems we talked about earlier with BI on Hadoop and the failures that we've seen with your traditional query tool. Qlik and Jethro together has created a solution that is very unique and very powerful for the big data market. So let's go ahead and recap the advantages of using Qlik and Jethro. So what we've seen is clearly the speed and performance benefit of using these two technologies together. You get true interactive Hadoop for business discovery, with all the technologies that Jethro brings to the table with progressive indexing, query acceleration, smart caching, parallelized queries. It really gives Qlik a unique and powerful capability for really, really finally giving Hadoop users intelligent visual analytics for Hadoop. Thank you very much. I appreciate the time.